Good morning, it's Captain Brian, and this morning's edition of Get Boativated, and welcome out. Hey, I'm just up here in Tennessee. We flew in yesterday and had a great flight in, flew into Knoxville, drove about a 45-minute drive, and now we're up near, just outside of Pigeon Ford in Sevierville. We rented over at Hearthside Cabins, rented a beautiful three-story log cabin on the side of a mountain, and it's just absolutely beautiful. You can see a little bit behind me here with down over the valley and doing that. Half the crew just ran out of the store to get some groceries and whatnot. But it is just a beautiful day out here, 75 degrees, supposed to be down to about 50 at night and enjoying the weekend. But getting on to what I'm going to talk about, what you can figure out if you got a little business going on or you're spending some money on a vacation and trying to figure out what direction to go. And location aside, just think about what you're shopping for. What is your best value for your dollar? This is our example today from our travels. We elected to save $20 on a car rental for the week. We'd rented a minivan that would take all six of us around and fit us in the car. And we saved, like, we priced them all out, and there's one that was like 20 bucks less, 20, 25 bucks. And so we went with it. So what the heck, let's go with it. Now, I'm not going to mention any car service names because that's not an issue. It's more of what you're paying for your value. Because we got the car, we got to the airport, flew in, landed, beautiful flight, got in, got down to the line. And that particular car rental service must have been giving a deal because our line was about 30 people long with one person behind the counter. And versus the five or six other car rental services had two people behind the counter with maybe one to two people in line. So we got stuck standing there for almost an hour to save that 20 bucks. Now, is that worth it for all six of us to sit at the airport waiting for that best value of $20? Excuse me, I don't think so. We're on vacation. We're gonna enjoy every time we can to relax and unwind and get our new mindset for going on. But no, we're stuck at the airport because we saved 20 bucks for that line. Any other car rental place we would have had, it would have taken us care of that and putting us around. So think about that when you're trying to, you think you're saving a little bit of money, but what is the value to the dollar for that? What is that savings going to do for you? Is that, you know, if it was up to me looking back on it, I would have paid 50 bucks more to have a pickup key right there just to go grab your, walk out to the lot and grab your key, which they have that, or grab your car. And they have that service available. But we went with the little lower end, so we got to be checked in, got to wait, then we had to go outside, wait in line for them to bring the car up. You know, and these other services where you just pay a little bit extra and you just walk right out to the parking lot, they tell you what parking slot number your car's in, you just go from there. So when you're thinking about it, if you got a little business and you're selling value over money, you know, you don't want to shoot for the cheapest customer. You want to shoot for the best value you can offer to give to your customer. And that's what's going to bring you back for more later. Unless, like you're on vacation for 7 days, 6 days. You know, you're at a limited amount of time to do for your free time. You don't want to be wasting it doing stupid stuff, waiting in lines, waiting to check into places, doing all that. You want to have the maximum value of what you can receive for your money as well. So if you're a customer, don't always go for the cheapest. Go for what looks the best and what's going to function the most for your vacation and what your time frame is and what you're doing. So that's just my thoughts for the day. We'll keep you posted. I got some other videos coming for the week. Looking forward to sharing some great experiences here up in Tennessee. And if it gives you an idea to get away and enjoy some cool weather and get out of the humidity if you're in Florida, or if you're up north and it's already cold, come down. It's a little bit warmer yet in the Smoky Mountains and enjoy a beautiful day of a little bit of paradise here. So I'm Captain Brian. Let's get motivated. We'll see you tomorrow.